you think it's perfect, then the feeling's worth it. When we're getting down, 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 down. If everything you've searched for is right here on the dance floor, and you want it now, 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 now. Don't know what you're there for, bring it over here in the middle of the crowd, inside my sound. Seeing through your... And then it was over. Welcome to another edition of Gotlegs. I put up a few videos as of late, and this is another one in a row. So, a couple of weeks ago, it was actually my birthday. I turned 33, and I actually got some pretty awesome presents. For once, I got the Lars Bak book, which is a Danish bike rider who released the book as recently. I also got some Mavic socks, and I got two jerseys, cycling jerseys, that I'm going to show you now. So this is the closet where I keep most of my bike clothing. And the first jersey that I got at my birthday, not the first jersey I got in total, was this. This, sip it up. This is a Black Sheep Flanders jersey. It has like dark green, orange sleeves. Got some badging right here. Let's see if we can zoom in on that. Badging right here. And all in all, pretty cool jersey. I really wanted to try Black Sheep for a long time. I think I've been looking at their stuff for about 3 or 4 years now, and just never had the opportunity to actually pull the trigger on a jersey. So luckily my girlfriend decided that she wanted to give me a very nice present. So this is it. I will be buying some bibs for it. Not sure if I'll buy Black Sheep bibs or probably just some Castelli Free Arrows, because those bibs are nice. So this is quite a lightweight jersey. Really cool jersey, has a lot of cool details. Posted some pictures on my Instagram a couple of weeks ago. Has the Black Sheep logo on the sleeves. Yada, yada, yada. Haven't given a go yet. Need some bibs for it. This is a size medium, and it fits me perfectly. So if you're going to buy anything from Black Sheep, they're pretty true to size. So the second jersey I got was this. And I never zip up my jerseys when they're just hanging on a coat hanger, so you'll have to bear with me on this. Yes! Probably can't pick up anything in this light. This is a MAAP jersey. I like MAAP. It's pretty similar to the 22 degree MAAP jersey I reviewed a few weeks ago. But this is blue, it's not black. And yesterday, the MAAP bibs came as well. So these are MAAP bibs. And MAAP really makes awesome bibs. I gotta say that. They're very nice quality. You have to pay for them because they're quite expensive, but they're really, really nice bibs. So this is like a blue, navy blue something with some pattern on it, green and blue and bit of red details. Such a nice kit. This is a medium jersey. So again, true to size, they're pretty. I like to have my jerseys fitting a pretty slim. And bibs are large because I have large quads. So these are the two jerseys that I just got. And I really don't know if I'll ever ride them this year. I will definitely ride them next year, but if the weather will be good enough for me to have my bike back with new wheels and everything, and the weather will still be warm enough to actually ride just a summer kit, basically. But such a nice presence. I actually also decided to clean up my bike room. So a lot cleaner than it was just a few weeks ago. So time trial frame. MV67s with DT Swiss hubs. Anything. Only thing missing really is the tarmac bike. So the tarmac bike is currently at my local bike shop, and the insurance is looking into it. But I talked with the insurance agent yesterday, and he said
that he'll look into it. So hopefully next week we'll have something to work out of. So I've just got confirmation that a package has arrived for me from Wiggle. So I'm gonna pick that up now. So let's do a bit of the unboxing. All right, so the package is open now, and let's see what I've ordered. So first thing, HJC. This is the replacement for the HJC Furin helmet that I crashed less than a week ago. So there you have it, basically the exact same helmet that I crashed. I really like this helmet. I recommend that you watch my 3-minute review of this helmet. It's my favorite helmet. I love this color. I haven't grown tired of it, so I bought the exact same model. That was pretty easy, right? What else do we have? Some energy drink. High Five recently got a new branding, so this is instead of the old isotonic that I used to use. Basically it should be the same, but you never know. So I've gotten a large bucket of this. This is 2.2 kilos and hopefully this will be a great mix with my scratch slabs, so interchanging between the two, not getting tired of either one. I've been using High Five for the last 6 years, if not more, and they're by far my favorite energy company. This is a new chain whip. It's not actually a whip. It's more something that you kind of like put down on the sprockets, and then it's a lot easier to remove the cassette. I have a chain whip already, but it's usually, I think it's a 10-speed chain that there's on it. So it doesn't really, it's not as good on my 11-speed wheels. It's kind of difficult to use it. So hopefully this will be even better. And I haven't really understood why you need a chain whip when you can basically get a tool that kind of grabs the cassette and then just hold it tight. It makes a lot more sense. This was like 10 or 12 British pounds on Wiggle. So if you're in Euroland, that's around basically the same, like 10, 12, 13 euros for this. So even if it's rubbish, it hasn't cost me that much. Then there's some wear and tear for my winter bike. Winter is coming. We're now in the latter part of September. Man, this year has just gone by so fast. A new 10-speed chain, Tram. This is the 1051. I think that's equivalent to a Rival, Tram Rival chain. So pretty good for winter riding. Doesn't need anything too fancy. And then just your old cassette. So this is the Shimano 105. Could probably have gone with like a Tiagra, but then again, I couldn't get the Tiagra in the sprockets configuration that I wanted. It was either 1125 or 1228 or something like that. And I like the 1128 for winter riding. Back in the day, I used to ride a compact chain set on the front, which was 5034, which is great for winter riding because you never really hit the speeds that you do in the summer, and if you do, it doesn't really matter that much on the cassette. But most of the riding is done at something like 27, 28, 29, below 30 kilometers an hour, especially if it's windy. And now I'm riding with a 52-36 configuration in the front, so I don't really mind the extra sprockets on this one, making sure that I can actually pedal a lower gear. So 1128, that was it. So in my search for new wheels, I haven't really gotten much smarter, but I ended up buying a set of wheels. They won't be my primary wheels, but they'll be a very nice addition to my lineup of wheels. So already I've got the Het Belgium Plus rims, which are laced to like a DCR hub with and basically my go-to wheel set on bad weather days and early spring, late fall. Then I have the NV67 wheels, which have the higher rim depth that are currently on the TT bike and that I can use in between everything. They're not a latest generation of NV wheels, so they don't have the new brake track or anything like that. So they're older wheels, but they actually do the job pretty well. They're not as wide as the newer wheels, and they, as I mentioned, have a worse brake track. Then I have the NV45s, which have now been crashed, and I need some new wheels. That was a different video. But I ended up browsing through eBay quite a lot, and on eBay I found a lot of pretty cool wheels that hadn't gotten that many offers, and the prices were still pretty low. And I actually decided to bid on a set of wheels. I ended up winning, so that was great. The wheels are Reynolds Attack tubeless compatible. I haven't really, or don't really know which year they are, but given from the graphics of the wheels, they look like the newer version, but not the newest version. They're tubeless clincher wheel, and they should come in at a weight around 1,365 grams, which is pretty light. And they are around the 30 mil rim height, 20 spokes in the front, 24 in the rear. And basically these will be my wheels for climbing. Now, I don't do a lot of climbing anyways. We have pretty flat roads here in Denmark, but once in a while we head to the south of France or some place else where I'll bring my bike along and I'll do some riding. And previously I've usually ridden a set of Criterium rims laced to tune hubs that were crazy light. They were like 1300 grams for a clincher wheel set. But the tune hubs broke on me numerous times, and I didn't really like the wheel set, so decided to sell that one. And I really kind of missed that low weight climbing wheel thingy, and I wanted to get something that was actually a carbon wheel, so not going with an alloy wheel. It's not that I dislike alloy wheels, I just really like carbon wheels. So these are new wheels that hopefully will come in soon. I got them for £459, which is pretty good. So just ran out of space on my memory card. So, but anyways, hopefully these wheels will soon arrive, and I'll give them a video and to see what they are. So that's it for me for now. Thanks for watching once again. Make sure to subscribe to the channel, watch the other videos, and until next time, bye.